Oh man, Erica just bust my head because Erica just did there, just did like what she said. V and Neo to her, they are fake. They're just acting it out. I'm like, wait, chill. Hey, homie, welcome back to my channel. How you doing? What's happening? My name is Omi Odike, and this is Talk to Your Homie TV, my darling. Here, I love to give very sweet and juicy gist. And today, we're talking Bibi Naija lockdown day 31. So today, we're talking about the Airtel challenge. Oh, man, what Erica did. Like, I'm sure in Kidwaya's body, he's burning. I can tell that he's burning. Oh, my gosh, I'm talking about that. And also, man, Kaisha had an interview with Ebukaye, and Kaisha is revealing to us things that we did not know in the house. There's a particular relationship that, you know, we have to ask a question because Kaisha thinks it's fake, Katrina thinks it's fake. I'm like, okay, so we chill. You know the saying that goes, if it smells like a dog and looks like a dog, it must be a dog here. So we're going to address that. Honey, subscribe to this channel because this is where it just goes down, really. And click the bell button to the subscribe button. That way, guess when I post a new video and get to watch all my cheese firsthand. One more thing, give this video a thumbs up because more thumbs up means more views. Now let us begin. I want to just quickly rush through the Airtel challenge here, or the Airtel task, yeah? So they're supposed to, so the Airtel task comes with like 400,000 naira. And it goes to charity. Whatever team that wins here, the money will go on their behalf to charity. Yeah, there are four teams. Let me see if I can remember the team. If I remember, that'll be crazy. But no, Lakers team is Leko Nengi, Tolani Bad, and V. Then Kidwire's team is Kidwire, Erica, and Tricky. And then Ozo's team is Ozo, Dirty, Watuni, and Omashola. Sorry, Omashola, sorry. You know, I keep calling Neo, Mashallah, why? They give me the same vibe. Neo is in the team. And then finally, the remaining Praise, Prince, Lucy, and Brighto. Oh, guys, I remember. So this current Airtel commercial, yeah, they gave them the lyrics and told them to, like, make a melody, like, sing it, like, do a proper presentation of the song, yeah. And, I mean, Leko is a musician. That's, I mean, he has refeatured Reminisce. He's pretty big. And V is a musician as well. So how can you put Leko and V in the same team? Get me. And you want any other person to win? Guys, from the rehearsal, Leko is so creative. Like, I was just watching it. This guy just started beating the drum with his hand. And then he just started giving them the melody. He said, okay, you know what? Negi and Tolani, give me this tune. He started giving him the tune. You know, in life, there, if you're supposed to do anything, don't, like, if they ask you, can you do this? That's one advice I got from Kemi Adetiba. Before I started my whole like media company, yeah. If they ask you, can you do something, say yes, then go and learn it. Don't say yes and flop. No, say yes, then go and learn it. That's like the best thing, because that way opportunities will come to you. So why am I saying this, yeah? After, because Leko was beating the drum, bringing the tune, he couldn't do everything. He could not beat the drum and sing as well. So they were like, see, they want a Fuji sound that can V. The V was like, ah, she cannot do it. Totally just said, V, no, try. Like that small ginger. We started though. Ah, see how, as in, I wish I can try to sing, but my singing voice is not all that. Our V said to drop this song. It was so sweet. You know, already my lover, my love got ill. Ah, oh my, it was nice. It was like, for the rehearsal, I knew that these people had won this thing. Oh my, then they now said, yeah, come and present it. Okay. Also, and Dorothy's team here, yeah, they kind of tried, yeah. But now, the mistake they made was that Lakers team was not the second team. Ah, oh my, as Lakers team go, as in, they killed it. They gave us different sounds. Different from Fuji to Azin. No. After them, Prince them came. Like, Prince's song was very laughable. They should use like a reggae song, she had to put in the word. But the one that was the funniest, yeah, was Kidwire and Erica's own. Oh my gosh. The mistake they made was making Leko them come before any other person, because as Leko them came, if you hear Leko's song, you said you go fear. They have been started to dance to Leko them song. Can you imagine? So I think Kid was trying to just ginger them up. Don't worry, be confident, be clinical. You know, oh man, they got there. Kid came and did his normal story. Oh guys, I'm here to tell a story. How, yeah, start this song. Oh man, as they started the song, that drama was just there. The music was just there. Oh man, now Erica just bust my head because Erica just did there, just did like what, she was laughing. Like, seriously, Trina. Presentation, Kid said. I'm sorry, guys. Please, let's take it from the beginning again, from the top. Let's go. I said presentation. They did it like. They made mistakes. Kid come and talk with me. I forgot to my like. I was just like, no man, no. I mean, allow it. You win some, you lose some. Kid has been winning almost all tasks. Get me? And I mean, let them lay her win. I've had the task now. Then I went inside to go and discuss the matter. Erica was like, see, the reason she laughed was because she felt silly. I mean, I understand. She just felt embarrassed at what she was doing. That normally when she's nervous or scared, she laughs, and I get that thing. Me too, I laugh. And she feels bad that she's an actress. She's supposed to be able to pull up an appearance. I mean, you're human, man. If you think you Jones, no matter the matter, you Jones. Just that, I mean, we need to just learn to have a game face. I kind of feel that Kid Wire, because the way winning is on Kid Wire's head, I feel like Kid Wire will be angry with Erica. She wants me to say, I apologize to him, but he was like, don't worry, it's okay. I mean, allow Nico and the scene win, because they see it's like a proper dance something. You will get up and are you joking? If you watch the presentation and you like Nico's, oh, please big them up in the comment section. Now let's go to Kaisha. So Kaisha has come to talk to Ebuka about a lot of things happening in the house. First of all, they asked her, like, do you think the housemaid did not like you? She was like, no. And she thinks that they just misunderstood her. Do you get me? They did not really understand her person, how she was and things. Ebuka was like, but like the first diary session, everybody was saying that, ah, we're happy here, but you just came and said that everybody in the house is fake. Explain to her. She was like, yes, because it did not make sense to her that she's coming to a house. You get me? This is like the first time meeting each other. Everybody's acting like they all know each other, they love each other. What's that? It makes no sense to her. So to her, that was fake. That was them acting very fake, yeah. And then next relationship, obviously the house, Ebuka is asking, yeah, like there was pressure. It felt like there was pressure to be in a relationship. Did she feel that pressure? She says no at all, no. Now of course there was a particular person she liked, which was new, and she liked new, yeah, but afterwards, man, the likeness died. Ebuka was like, really? She was like, yeah, that it wasn't any particular reason, but the fact that, like, on the first day when they came into the house, on their way there, Neo was behind her, and Neo kept on asking her questions about who are you, like, just trying to know more about her. So she felt like, ah, who is this person who wants to know me? That's why she really likes Neo. And then, see, don't get it twisted, though. V or no V, get me? She did not send V, she liked Neo, but later, the likeness shot dropped. Shot. They did not ask her this Pepe question. The question goes, the relationship in the house, which one was real and which one was fake? You said Omo to her. A lot of the love couple were seeing was fake. The only one that she felt was real, the only connection she felt was Leko, Kid Wire, and Erica, because she felt like, or it seemed like, or she kind of believes that Leko likes Erica. Obviously, he does. And then Erica really likes Kid Wire, but Kid Wire, she's not sure, because to her, Kid Wire is a player. Okay, does Kid Wire give you player vibes? Tell me in the comment section. Then next, Ozo and Nengi. She said, yeah, that she can feel that Ozo really likes Nengi, but Nengi, she's not really sure, because Nengi said she has a boyfriend outside the house, so she's not really, really sure. But now, the one that is getting me, I want to talk about this one with you. She said V and Neo to her, they are fake, they're just acting it out. I'm like, wait, chill. Are they really fake? Because if Katri, because I mean, we're not in the house, you get me? These people that lived with them, they can tell us more about the whole thing, yeah? So if Katrina says V and Neo are fake, and Kaisha is saying the same thing, do you think they're fake? Do they give you fake? I mean, they don't give me fake vibe. I just feel like V with Neo is killing Neo's game. I feel like, I'm gonna V be the man. Like, V, you know, she get ginger. She has no thought it was street. V has come and show him that, honey, I am the street. Don't you understand? In London, I was living on the street. Well, not living on the street, but she grew up in the hood side. So she's, I don't know. To me, she has just softened new up, is what I feel. But what do you think? Do you think they're fake? Do they give you fake vibe? I also saw in the comment section, somebody actually said that V and Neo were, like, their quarrel was acting quarrel. Do you think so? I mean, I would like to know, though. Talk to me in the comment section. And finally, they're not asking, like, who does she think will win? So, like, man, the person she's waiting for is Dirty. Why? Because Dirty is one person, according to Kaisha, who has stuck to her game. She has not faked it. She has not changed from the beginning to the end till now. She's been herself 100. Which housemate do you think has changed? Are you feeling any vibe from anybody that's changed? I have one or two names in my... I have just one name. I'm going to tell you until you tell me who you think, you know, has changed or who was faking. I really want to know, because I don't know. Dorothy has been consistent, I can't lie. Ozo, I don't know, man. When I think of Ozo, the only excuse that I have for Ozo is the fact that he has sister. So maybe that's why he's, you know, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know at all. I don't know. But Ozo, initially I was like, oh, Ozo. But right now I'm just like, oh, let me just study Ozo more. Then who again do I want to talk about? I want to hear your opinion, though. Which housemate do you think has changed? Who do you think is real? You get me? Let me know in the comment section. And who, you know, let's even start predicting. Which housemate do you think will win the money? Who do you think will win the money? If you ask me, as at today, I think it's between Leko, Dirty, and Nengi. These three is what I think. chances are. But I think top five, Lekor, Dirty, Nengi, definitely. As at today, Bibi Nanja, you watch it every day, like watch it one day at a time. Anybody can do, get me? But Lekor, Dirty, Nengi, I think also Kid Wala. Ah, top five for Erica. Huh? Erica and Prince, I'm not sure, but Lekor, Dirty, Nengi. I mean, it depends on the voters, but just what I'm saying so far, you get me? Lekor, Dirty, Nengi, Kid Wire, what's his boy's name? Also, let's put Erica somewhere, let's put Prince somewhere. I think top seven, that's it. But anyway, so tell me your own opinion in the comments section. One more thing, I tried to do like YouTube live, that was obviously, I won't say it was a flop, I stayed up all night to try to figure it out. I wasn't able to figure out the whole mic thing. That would, if it had worked, that would have been perfect for me. I'd have been doing like live, like maybe how many times in a day, I'd have been going live often. But the comments are saying, "Omi, the audio," and I give you what you want. So I'm not going to do that anymore. So we're going to go back to, you get me, like me talking to you and saying, "Well, you know, I love you. That's why I take the risk to do everything I do, my honey." Then one more thing, let me just show you guys. We are expanding. I told you, yeah, I'm trying out new colors. So we just launched a new color for our loungewear, and this, my darling. Let me know, go and do this. My tummy not be. I guess I need to push my chair away. This is exactly how it is. It's the same as the black, but this material is a whole lot better. See, one thing about me when it comes to my merchandise is the material. I want to make sure that if you get my clothes, the material, you'll be like, you say, "Thank God I bought it." I'm not just selling because stuff your home is there. No, I want you to be able to wear it forever, yeah? And of course, you know, you can wear this top on a proper jeans and a blazer and heels and get me, like you can flaunt with it and do whatever you want to do, but yeah. The shorts is here. It makes you look sexy. You can stay at home with your man alone with my loungewear. Then Talk to Your Homie logo is here. Talk to Your Homie is here as well. So my darling, please order my merch. Buy Talk to Your Homie merch. It is just 7,000 naira. Send me a mail at hello@talktoyourhomie.com to buy it. I love you guys so much. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your comments and everything. Bye-bye.